Alexandra, I think, made 100 jello shots. Very excessive.
Thanks, Fledge. Zoe, I do not care.
See, Alexandra
not
said...
Not needed. There were not 100 people there.
No, absolutely not. And I think there's jello shots maybe still in the fridge.
Yeah, there's there a lot be. Left over.
Yeah.
And I mean, what's the percentage of partygoers that typically are like, I want a jello shot?
Not many. Yeah,
I was offered a shot immediately upon walking in the door. Yeah. It was at this point I felt very proud. Kat McNamara, friend of the show, came up to me and said, oh my God, I'm such a huge fan. And I was like, this is so crazy. That's so sweet of you. And she walked away and Sarah went, Miles, she's a superstar.
What happens to your clothes when you, you know,
wolf out?
Yeah. When you're out, you touch me so deep, my head's in the clouds. I'm biting my lip, I'm screaming out loud. There's no way to stop it now. I can feel my body drowning, but there's no use. Where I stand, you're just some guy in my way.
My name is Mia Smoke. I'm Felicity's daughter.
I wish I got to know him. I know, but he lives on in the two of you.
This is not the will of the angels,
but it's my will.
So that was very exciting for me.
You have been actually acting since you were a wee little thing. A
little bit.
Right?
Yeah.
How has it been? Like, how do you avoid some of the pitfalls that other child actors have had?
Well, it's so interesting because I never initially intended to be an actor.
Really?
I wanted to go into finance. That's actually what I got my college degree in, was business. And I sort of fell into this by accident, but fell in love with it instantly. And I think the most important thing is surrounding yourself with people who know you for who you are at your core.
Right.
And aren't involved in sort of the glitz and glamour of the industry. And people who are very grounded and can support you in a very healthy way.
Very good. That's a very great philosophy.
Do you want an omelet? Social media is wrought with embarrassing moments for me. I don't know if anybody's ever gonna see this. I have no reception. My internet is down. I didn't film that. How long have I been friends with the Try Guys? Pretty much since the pandemic. I've been a fan of the Try Guys for a long time. And then I just sent them a message thanking them for, you know, keeping all of us entertained during the pandemic when there wasn't much else to do. So guys, this is my quarantine boyfriend. We're very happy together. We like to work out and watch movies and cook. He's a really good listener. And they were being so creative and coming up with content and still making it joyful. And then we got to chatting and, you know, they're wonderful. So I'm so thrilled that we got to be buds.
Joining us today is our good buddy, Kat McNamara. She's from the TVs, and now she's on here with us.
Hey guys, I'm Katherine McNamara, and I'm so excited to be here with the Try Guys today. You know, they really made my daisy by asking me to come join them for this video. Ow.
I wish you the best. I don't know how you're gonna do that, quite honestly. As long as you can be kind to yourself, patient with yourself, and if you have a little bit of taste, you'll be all right. You know, that's part of it. I can't teach you everything.
Oh, they're edible arrangements.
Oh my God, you know those are like my favorite thing on the planet.
Really?
Duly noted.
They're so ugly. But I love them.
Oh my God.
Oh, this one's gorgeous.
It's so beautiful.
Guys, I believe in us. We got this.
You have to take all of them out.
Oh.
Kat, undo the paper.
Oh, they're in bunches. I see.
Stripping.
Okay.
You don't have to tell me size.
Oh, it's already off.
Yeah, he said, I'm so sorry.
This is a stripper. And this is what you use to strip roses. You take this and you gently scrape it across and you have a stripped rose. If you want to make it look like a bigger flower than what it is, you can do what's called a reflex. You can just take each petal and kind of fold it under with your thumb to one direction, or you can like blow on it. Which will make you a little lightheaded, but it totally works.
Treat your roses like Nintendo cartridges.
Yeah. Would not be allowed to use scissors. You have to use a knife. However, I'm not hiring any of you people.
You might hire us.
You might. What if we're savants?
There is a slim chance. How you use a knife, this is the basic principle. So put the shit down. Did I tell you to do? Anyways, your thumb never moves. If you move your thumb, you are cutting yourself.
Ooh, yeah, that. Mm-hmm.
You're stressing me out.
Mm-hmm, I'm stressing me out.
We're gonna cut off TV star Kat McNamara.
You're gonna stick to the scissors?
Okay. I'm just gonna watch a few other people do it first.
You're not gonna
beautiful.
Get anything done.
Yes,
like
that.
That's
yes.
Really weird.
Yeah, I don't trust this at all. Not for a second. I'm gonna slice my thumb off.
I can't wait to use the scissors.
Hey!
Yeah, yeah. Oh, I love you.
No!
Ow!
Ow!
Oh.
Pricked myself on a thorn, just like that.
Look at this surface area, and you look at this amount of surface area.
You drink more. It's like the difference between my mouth and Keith's mouth.
It's exactly like that.
You can suck more.
You got it.
Now, would you call them birds of paradise, bird of paradises?
Girl, relax.
Girl with the flow.
Calm down. We're gonna pop these birds of paradises. Or as I like to say, pop these
That's also what I'll say.
You can run this under warm water, and then it makes it really easy to like slide in and get your finger under that surface right there.
A little bit sensual, huh?
Wow.
And then you're just gonna like let it come out, and it just like comes a little bit.
Oh shit.
Oh my God.
Why am I turned on by flower?
This is hot.
Wow.
Wow. Oh my God, I feel like I need a cigarette after that.
Woo!
Metal ball.
This is art in and of itself.
Right?
Yeah.
And it's the art that no one will ever see.
And that's what really counts. It's at the core of it all, at the root of it all. Mm. Oh. Wow, look at you.
Thanks.
Carnation's already in lingerie. It's done a lot of work here.
It's much more romantic.
What would your guys' flower shop be if you opened one up?
Kind of like what incarnation?
What incarnation? That's good.
Keith Habersberger's Flower Hut.
I like it.
Wait, so you literally save room for Jesus in your designs?
Quite literally, yeah. You constantly want to be turning your arrangement. You constantly want to be placing. Are you texting?
I'm taking notes.
Wow.
We're taking notes.
Straight up as I'm giving you gold.
I'm feeling okay. I think my shape is better. My color differentiation and variety is better.
Do you feel like you're letting all the flowers shine, or does it look like a jumbled mess?
Well.
Are you proud of us?
Some more than others.
Okay.
Some more than others.
Whoa.
And he hates
pie. I'm gonna give you a 7.5.
That's better.
Oh, that is better. Look at that.
Fuck you are, Eugene.
Kat, thank you for allowing us to know what it's like to have none of us lose.
It's
happy,
huge.
Happy to be
this. It's huge for us.
Yeah. Did we ever tell the story about how we got Kat McNamara's car towed?
You know, you did.
Oh, yeah.
She just texted me a whole bunch of movies for Guilty Pleasure, so hopefully we'll have her on in a few weeks.
Oh,
but
that's a blast.
That was funny.
That was a funny
story. It's not my story. I'm going to sit back and I'm going to listen. Well, tell me a story, Keith and Ned.
Well, you know, there we were. Kat McNamara.
TV very, and movie star.
Very, yeah, famous actress.
Right.
And she was there with doing the flower videos. We did Try Guys Make $1,000 Flower Bouquets. Mm-hmm.
Such a fun day.
She's so sweet. Very, very funny. Very punny. Lots of great puns.
But he's solid. I can vouch for that, right, honey?
We're in a part of town that doesn't have a lot of great parking. It's just like this certain little area of LA that really has almost no parking. It's very odd. So we said, hey, where should we park? And our production team, at the advice of our expert, said, oh, well, generally people park in this Home Depot lot and it works out.
And I was like, are you sure? Because any other time I've parked in like, oh, just in the 7-Eleven. Oh, just park in the Home Depot lot. It doesn't end well.
And
they were like, yes, he says he parks there all the time without any issue.
I felt terrible too because it was not the nicest part of Los Angeles. We have Kat coming who's like
downtown
this.
Downtown LA.
You know, there's like literally a dead rat run over in the parking lot.
Oh my
there's,
God.
You know, some seedy folk walking around and poor Kat's like, hey, welcome to your first Try Guys shoot. It was
here
not.
We are.
It was, didn't really seem that well buttoned up. Like, yeah, just park in the Home Depot parking lot
right.
around the.
Zach and I had carpooled. Mm-hmm. So we parked and also Ned parked and Kat parked in this Home Depot parking lot.
And when we get done with the shoot,
we're
looking for our cars. And I'm like, I'm pretty sure I parked over here.
Oh.
And me and Kat, you know, we walked to the parking lot together and then we were like, okay, bye. Like, I'm this way. And then I'm like looking around for my car. And I'm like, I think I parked it over here. And then I try and, you know, look some like I kind of work my way inside and then I see Kat and she's kind of like looking around for her car too. And then I look, you know, on my, you know, my car has an app which tells me where it is. And then I see, oh no,
it's not here.
It's somewhere else.
It's gone.
Probably been towed.
And then they text us saying our cars are towed and we're like, fuck. And I'm like, oh fuck, because I haven't left the set yet. So I like run. Adrenaline full, like, oh no, not me too.
Our whole crew, by the way, everyone on the crew was like,
everyone.
I was like, please, not me. And then I get to the parking lot, and I had strategically, somewhat, parked in the one lane that is between the Home Depot area parking and between the other businesses' area parking.
Clever
and
girl.
I parked next to like three big, like, trucks that looked like contractor trucks.
Mm-hmm.
So I just parked there, and I have kind of a big car as well. So I was like, I hope so. And I got back and it was still there.
And not everyone else's car was still there. It was just Ned and Kat.
It was just theirs. But they, so then I'm like, Ned and Kat, get in my car. We got 30 minutes to get to the tow lot before they close.
Yeah.
But I also needed to pick up Zach.
If you get here in 30 minutes, it's $300. If you get here in 31 minutes, it's $500.
Tomorrow.
Yeah. And then, so we're like, fuck, we got to go. We get Zach in the car.
And
we
get all cash.
We all also have four giant bouquets of flowers in the car. So we're running with giant lavish bouquets.
We got to go.
Tell me about your piece.
Okay, so this is my creation. Her name is Petunia. She is vibrant, she's colorful, she just wants to spread a little bit of joy. She might be a little rough around the hedges, but you know, she's just trying to grow with the flow.
Grow with the flow?
Just have to let go of everything. Be in the moment, get a flow, a rhythm.
Wow, I love puns.
I told you I loved a good pun. I'm sorry.
I will say that overall, color placement, really well done. I think the way that you use the pinks and you divided your blues, I like that. I think that your shape is a little strange.
Oh, we gotta go. And then we get to the tow place. I get them out and then realize they need cash. So
and
like,
we pool all our cash together, but we don't have enough.
So I was like, I had some cash. We had enough cash to get Kat's car out.
Yeah.
And then Ned didn't have any cash to get his car out. So our producer, Nick, had to get over there to get him some cash.
So I'm just waiting here like, Nick, how far are you? He like swings by, like hands some cash out the window. I grab it. I'm like, okay, now we have enough.
But you also have to picture that Ned and Kat are in this downtown tow lot holding giant bouquets of flowers.
Valued at like $500. Like just the most
four
beautiful.
4 foot tall, just gorgeous.
Birds of paradise shooting out.
Birds of paradise are shooting out like fireworks in a way that feels aggressive. And then there's just an eruption of delphinium right down the center that kind of doesn't have anything to do with anything. I thought you did a pretty good job of incorporating it here. However, the way that you used it here only got you a 3.
Okay, I'll take it.
All right.
That's a good number.
Your overall arrangement, I'm gonna give you like a very generous 7.
Wow, thank you.
And it's like very hot. And she's just such a sweetheart. She never once was like, ugh, this is the worst day
Fuck
of
you
my
guys.
Life,
yeah.
You stupid Try Guys.
She never stopped smiling.
Felt horrible. I'm like, oh my God, this. We're like, have a guest on set and their cards.
The worst thing that could happen.
Yeah, I'm like, oh
And
my
she was
God.
The first like, no, don't give me your money. I'll wait for Nick. I'm like, no, take the money and get out of here. This is a terrible place to be.
When Keith and I went to go pick them up, because we're like, oh fuck, Ned sounds pissed. Like, they're not going to be in a good mood. And Kat's like, hey guys, oh, thanks for the ride.
It's so sweet.
Like,
she
was I was so pissed because it's like I'm a little pissed because my own car was towed or whatever, but I was mostly pissed when it's like we're running a production.
I mean, I'll run my own production company someday.
And we have air of like we should be professional towards our guests. We need to have parking that is, you know, spoken for, not just like cobbling it together.
Wild West parking out here.
So check out Arrow on the CW and catch your reruns of Shadowhunters. Kat McNamara, she's a great friend of the show, friend of the pod. We should have her on the podcast.
That'd be wonderful.
Everyone's talking just to fill some space, and everything's nothing till it means heartbreak. Words without power just evaporates. Don't wanna hear
it. For the pearl of secret pageant.
What did Indra tell you, Tyler?
I don't know what he's been filling your head with about me, but I know it's not true.
You get a much closer view through this thing.
Quit her?
I don't know
why. Seriously, be sure to see Spirit of Friday Free, Spirit of Christmas, available on Netflix.
Come on, Guilty Pleasures in a few weeks. She just texted me 11 movie options. She originally kept saying, she kept saying Princess Bride, and I'm like, that is the best movie ever. You can't, that's not a good movie. That is just... Yeah. What is well regarded as one of the most loved movies of all time. Happy to talk about it.
It's like a little bit of a cult classic, maybe, though. Like, was it a box office?
One of the biggest movies ever.
It's
a four-quadrant hit.
Is that right?
Kids, adults, men, women, everybody loves never ending that story. Movie.
Recite your favorite line from The Princess Bride.
As you wish. I did a movie with Cary Elwes a few years ago, and Princess Bride has always been one of my favorite films of all time. And it was right when his book came out. So he gave me a copy. And if you love The Princess Bride, this book is so beautiful. It really does go through the entire process. And Cary has such a love for the film that it's a beautiful read. Highly, highly recommend it.